She had about 5 or 6 girls. The parcel gift, was in a tampon box. David threw a wobbly about that. By that I mean his body became very tense and he stomped around the room. He said it was disgusting. He eventually stomped out of the room. Ottawa always had part-time jobs and was in demand as a babysitter. Following in her parents' footsteps, she went to Teachers College in 1993, where she excelled and carried on with her interests in drama and photography. The college also awakened her interest in learning the guitar. Her quest for normality appeared to be on the right track. Of all the children, Laniet probably struggled most on the family's return from PNG. Bayfield High School teacher Joanne Dryden, who taught all the Bain children, found Laniet needed help. "Now and again I find a student who I take under my wing and who has needs or something they are crying out for." She was one of those students. Much to her parents' dismay, Laniet left both school and home towards the end of 1993, when she was 17. She told friends she had no income because her parents would not sign the forms to get her on a welfare benefit. It's not clear whether Laniet was forced to leave home or left of her own accord. Friends speak of problems between her and the domineering Margaret, and Laniet rebelling against the religious culture at home. Laniet also told a friend about the wall she and her mother had built between them. If her stories are to be believed, Laniet had, by the age of 17, already lived a life of calamity and misfortune. She told Paul Hewson, a physical education teacher at Bayfield, that she had been raped and had a black baby in Papua New Guinea. Later, having apparently forgotten she'd told him about the black baby, she said she had had an abortion and then attempted to kill herself by slashing her wrists.